مرحبا يا جماعة. We're gonna have a lesson today. بدنا نقدم درس اليوم. درس كثير مهم. لأنه we're talking about the فعل, the verb hut. Hut, I guess we could call this a mega verb, nuclear. يعني لأنه it's from the أول خمس أفعال that we use, the first five, top five, you could say, in the Arabic language for Amiya. So, hut, we're going to look at some verbs today from hut. How do we use them? And by the way, these are found in the 101 and even more in the 101 book. So if you don't have a copy of that, you should get it. That's Christine, what do we have here? Let's خلينا نط بالبركة و يعني فورا بدنا نشوف الأفعال.
هلا أول استعمال للفعل hut. بقدر أستعمل فعل hut مع إشي. وبستعمل حرف الجر يا إما على أو في.
Okay, so this is hut is placed or put on. Put, that's the ground. The asas for this verb is to put or place. So he put, he placed, he put something on something. Could be anything or in. فممكن نحكي يعني خلينا نحكي جملة.
مثلا حط الكتاب على الطاولة. حط الأكل في الثلاجة.
ممتاز. حط الأكل في الثلاجة أو حط الكتاب. حط الكتاب الكتاب على الطاولة. Okay, good. الثاني.
هلا تاني استعمال حط بس بقدر استعملها يا إما مع خطة مع جدول أو هدف.
Alright. معناته حط here. Now here's where we see a little different. A little difference in this. We're gonna try. Let's go with this. We're gonna go crazy here, and we'll put a little red in there. All right. Okay. Good. All right. So here we have put, right? Well, now on this one we have, you're gonna see made. So he made a plan. Hat chutta, chutta is plan. Okay. Made a schedule. Schedule is jadwal. Jadwal, schedule. Also means stream. But for this, it's a schedule. Okay, made. And then here we have put forth a goal or set a goal. So you see how these come different with the direct object. Put, we don't say put a plan, but in English we say made a plan, made a schedule, made a goal, made an. Okay, so as you can see on the screen here, we have made a plan, made a schedule, put forth a goal or set a goal. Christine, Altina. جملة كمثال.
هلا حط خطة بحكي الشركة مثلا الشركة حطت خطة لهاي السنة.
منيح. Okay, so the company put a plan or made a plan for this year.
صحيح. حط جدول ممكن أحكي المدير حط جدول للموظفين.
Okay.
تمام.
Made a schedule for the employees.
وحط هدف بحكي صاحبي حط هدف جديد في بداية السنة.
Great. Set a goal for the new year. Good. طيب. اللي بعده. المعنى اللي بعده.
حط حجة أو حط عذر. حجة وعذر تقريبا هم نفس المعنى.
Alright. Yeah. So here we have these. حجة أو عذر تقريبا. We could say they're excuse. So gave an excuse. حط in this instance has this meaning of gave. So, gave an excuse.
هلا إذا مثلاً دي أستعملهم في جملة بحكي الولد حط حجة عشان ما يأكل.
Good. So, the boy gave an excuse so that he doesn't have to eat.
بالضبط. Yeah. الموظف حط عذر عشان تأخر.
All right. So, the employee gave an excuse as to why he was late.
بالضبط.
All right.
تمام.
So let's. That's good. Let's see some more meanings from this.
هلا عنا استعمال الفعل حط مع كلمة حد مع حرف الجر لا. بحكي حط حد لا. إما الموضوع أو المشكلة أو لأشخاص لناس.
Okay. So here we have this one. It's really this one is hard to figure out unless you are given it to. That's why we give these lessons, right, Christine Mashaik? Now, this one we say in English, put a stop to. So this is how you say put a stop to. Hut had. Had is a singular from hudud. Hudud is the what we say borders for a country. They use the plural for that, not the singular. So here we have had is that actually has a shaddi on it, but حط حد لي للموضوع means put a stop to the sub or the issue. The issue. موضوع, what are we talking about? Mm-hmm. It's a problem or any type of issue. حط حد للموضوع. Mm-hmm. Or for the problem, put a stop to the problem or put a stop to someone. Mm-hmm. So this is where we say I put a stop to him doing what he did. Mm-hmm. But in بالعربي we don't even have to continue. We could just say للعماد أو للشخص معين.
صحيح.
Mm-hmm.
صحيح.
Good.
هلا خامس استعمال هو حط إشي أو ناس أشخاص عند.
Mm-hmm. So this is where we could say in this instance we're going to have this meaning of left. So left someone with. And has this idea of with. So we left someone and like with them at their house or wherever they are. So for example, أعطينا جملة كريستين.
ممكن نحكي حطيت أولادي عند أهلي.
Good. All right. So I left my kids with my parents.
بالضبط.
Yeah. عند أهلي.
بالضبط.
معناته with my parents, we don't have to say house.
صحيح.
Mm-hmm. And we can also say for money, you know, I gave the money, I left the money with, or it's almost like gave, but we say left with. Yeah, I left something with someone.
هلا ممكن أحكي مثلا حطيت السيارة اللي هي إشي حطيت السيارة عند المطعم مثلا الفكرة إنه أنا زي صفيت السيارة عند تركتها هناك.
Yeah, بالضبط. Okay, with the mechanic and mechanique.
صحيح.
اوكي والسادس
اخر استعمال اللي هو حطت مكياج
حطت مكياج بكل بساطة they're gonna say we put this is put on without على so the you know you have this on you think of على but it's nothing we don't use that بالعربي we just say put on makeup حطت مكياج مكياج is makeup all right excellent وصلنا للنهاية I think right
صحيح
واو برافو كريستين we have يعني درس كتير ممتاز مفيد إن شاء الله استفدتوا من هال من هال درس we'll see you in part 2 part 1 this is part 1 we'll see you in part 2 part 2 we're going to talk about تعبير expressions from it okay so منشوفك المرة الجاية